So she left you in Rome by yourself at 15?
No, by myself, with my cousins.
With your cousins.
Oh, yes.
Because she felt that you had a passion for this, or because it was a question of trying to get some money?
It was a dream for every girl. It was not really a passion, but dreams here and there, and wanting to really live a better life.
Were you scared at 15? I mean, your granddaughter, my daughter, is 14.
Yeah.
I couldn't imagine Lucia at 15 in 1 year being by herself in a big city trying to make it. How did it make you feel?
No, I was anxious. But I mean, if you have nobody to take care of you, you can be anxious just without, you know. Yeah, I am anxious, yes. I am afraid, yes.
You deal with it.
Who is going to help me? Nobody, so shut up. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I had to shut up and stay with my cousin that I didn't know, not very well. I didn't know them very well.
Sono stata chiara, ho chiuso.
E Joseph, allora?
Ma lascia perdere. Quella doveva restare solo una settimana. Sono mesi che la madre non si trova.
But they were very helpful because, you know, if they give you a place to sleep and something to eat in the morning, it's wonderful because then you think you have a family. Mm-hmm. But it was not so because they thought about their own family, so that was okay for me.
Ti voglio bene, mi hai portato I candelabri, pago l'affitto, ma morirei, vattene va.
So I started to live there and started to know a little bit people going into offices. Sometimes they started to call me just to say, well, we have this. Do you want to come to the office?
Because for work as an extra.
As, yeah. Always not as an actor. No.
Just as an extra.
So I did. So I started to know many, many people, many people. And that's little by little. The first film I made as an extra. It was Quo Vadis, with Elizabeth Taylor was there.
Did you ever tell Elizabeth Taylor that you were an extra in one of her movies?
No, she
when you met her?
She was never with me.
No, but when you ended up meeting
no,
her as Sophia Loren.
No. She was, So I started to put little money on the side, and then I started to have not a car, but un tram, come si chiama?
To go on the tram.
Tram, sì, to go to Cinecittà. At that time, my mother had come
back, yes.
Back to be with me, to see what I was doing. And we were making, for us, wonderful money.
Pensavo che il ragazzo potrebbe darvi una mano ogni tanto, così per tenerlo occupato durante l'estate.
Questi tempi di affari non è che vadano granché.
No, ma io vi chiedo solo di tenerlo due o tre volte alla settimana, non tutti I giorni, eh.
Some people, there's that myth of the overnight success. There's that myth that people say, overnight I became the star. When people met you when you were 15, 16, 17, did they already feel, my goodness, this person is unbelievable. There's such a beauty, magnetism, magic, or it wasn't like this? They slowly discovered it. How was that first reaction when people met you?
Nothing.
When you, eh?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
No, because when you don't have money, when you are a little bit miserable, people even look at you in another way because the expression is not the same. Or when you have a lot of money, you have a luminous expression there. There was no luminous expression.
So you had a certain insecurity about you.
Oh, yes, yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Oggi tocca a te.
The movie, The Life Ahead, tells the story of two survivors. One side, there is Madame Rosa, who is a Holocaust survivor. And on the other side, you have Momo, whose mother died when he was very young. Are you a survivor?
Che significa?
Do you see yourself?
Oh, yes.
Do you see yourself as a survivor in life?
Se non è una cosa negativa,
no.
Sì.
Do you see yourself as a survivor?
Yes.
How?
To live. to live, to be somebody, to be able to survive. If I didn't have the chance to have all these wonderful and positive things ahead of me without knowing, of course.
You know, you started at 15. Is there anything that your wisdom, now that you've gone through life having learned so many things, is there anything that you can help young actors with, that you could impart that sort of wisdom
with? It all depends how you feel inside. It all depends. How do you respect yourself? It all depends on always positive and wonderful things, but it's very difficult to have them all.
So self-respect is important?
Oh, yes.
Ma non lo sa. Che fai qui?
Non mi andava più di stare a letto.
Was it difficult to be directed by me?
Always. Always. Always.
Because?
No.
Well, I remember.
Because
you can say the truth.
You see inside out, you know. It's. I can see from your face if it's okay what I'm answering, if it's not okay. So I can just stop a little bit and... But the color in the face don't change. No, because I've had it so many of these things that I'm accustomed to it, so it's okay.
Yeah. Is it...
You are free. It's okay.
Is it more difficult working with your son or with another director that isn't part of your family?
No, ma per carità. Non voglio più dare nulla a nessuno. Promettimi. You are you.
Promesso.
There's nobody like you. Your brother, there's your brother and you. Of course.
The seminal relationship that you had with a director was with Vittorio De Sica. What did he teach you?
To be myself, not to be afraid of the things that you see when you're shooting. Just think about the character you have to play. Mm-hmm. Be serious. Very simple. Very simple. Mm. Be yourself. Mm. If you have to.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you have to face the character, and you will be you'll be your character that you have to play in the film.
Hashem et.
Hashem.
Ho detto Hashem.
No. Hai detto Hashem.
In this character, Madame Rosa has this amazing combination of drama, but also on the edges of the character, there's always a certain comedic tone.
I ragazzi mi hanno sempre chiamato Madame Rosa.
Chiedo scusa, Madame Rosa.
Scuse non accettate.
Which is really the hallmark of a certain Neapolitan identity.
Oh, there is, yeah, of course.
So talk about what being Neapolitan means to you and how it helped you in the building of this character, but really in your career as an actor.
No, but you become yourself. I mean, if you are Neapolitan and you are born a Neapolitan, you are born with everything like this inside of you.
Ma che è sta cosa? Che fumi?
Parma fragola.
La fragola?
Non ti piace?
Ma buttala di là, ma che schifo, la fragola. Il fumo è tabacco, non è una Macedonia.
And it comes naturally, it comes even when you speak, even when you say things, you always think that you're saying a serious thing, but inside of yourself you say, I would like to say it in the other way, but shut up, Sophia. This is something like, yes, because you like very much the comic side,
yes,
of life.
Yes.
Let's say, of life.
Yes.
And it's beautiful because you spend your time sometimes in thinking about silly things, but you think they're silly, but they're not silly.
Yeah.
They're very important, yeah, for you. And I am Neapolitan, I mean, 100%.
Yeah.
Even though I was born in Rome, but nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
Nothing to do with it.
When you start thinking of a character, there are two ways that actors approach a character. They start from the inside of the character and then go outwards with the costumes, the hair, the makeup. Or some actors start with the look and that look starts to inform the inside. Who are you? Do you start first with the appearance and then that informs, or you start first within and then the appearance?
Both.
It's a combination for you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You cannot split the two things, no. Mm-hmm. Impossible.
Was there a moment in the shooting that you felt, now I know her, now I feel comfortable, now I know what I'm doing in this role?
Well, you always think about that in the beginning of a
of a shoot, yes.
When you make the test, mm-hmm. and when you start to have a dress on, and when you start the makeup, little by little you understand that you are understanding the character.
Yes.
While you're doing all this, mm-hmm. because it's a kind of a preparation. It's all so much alive, everything, so much alive. Every gesture that you make, you think about the film. But I don't want to admit it because it seems silly. No, it's not silly, it's true.
Yeah.
When you have to do something that you know that it's very important for your career, in your life, then you, whenever you move, whenever you talk, whenever you do things in life, you know that why you are always so keen about knowing what you're doing, yeah. because you are preparing yourself,
yes.
to be able to be that one.
Madame Rosa!
What I very much love and admire is that the audience gets to see in the beginning of the movie the Sophia Loren or the characters that you've portrayed in the past that they love. You know, the vitality of the character, the strength of the character, the comedy of the character. But gradually, as the movie progresses, there's an illness that comes inside of you. And there's one specific scene in the movie that we shot together where you have this so-called mental paralysis under the rain. And so you have to not move your face anymore because you're like frozen, you're mentally frozen. And when we turned on the rain and you were, because we had studied it.
Don't say it.
What?
Don't blink.
Yeah, do you remember? No, hold on.
I'll never forget it.
Let me set it up.
We all drain all over.
Yeah, let me set it up. Hold on. So we were rehearsing the scene and we hadn't turned on the rain and your face was perfect. It was because we went to a doctor and he showed us images and videos of people suffering those symptoms. So we really made sure that it was authentic and legitimate medically. And there was no rain, it was all good. But when the rain started coming, obviously the droplets fell on your on your eyes, in your eye, and you started to blink. And when you blinked, it looked like you were too present. And I asked you, so what did I ask you?
Don't blink. And I didn't blink.
How did you not blink?
I know.
You did it. Because when I was cutting the movie, when I was starting to cut that scene, I was like, she's gonna blink. And it's gonna really, I tell you, if she blinks, it's gonna be such a problem. And we were looking at the scene and the rushes, and you did not blink. It's physically impossible not to blink.
I still remember.
But how did you not blink?
I will never forget it, that moment in my life.
But how did you not blink?
I don't know. It's because I'm a good actress? No. Just happened.
Ma siete pazzi? Che state facendo? Non vedete che sta piovendo?
Sei tu che non lo vedi.
You're known in your career for emotional scenes. You're known for expressing yourself emotionally.
To women.
And that emotion communicates a lot. Are those emotional scenes hard for you? Or do you access that emotion quite easily?
I don't sleep at night. Because if you want to do it well, you have to really know what you're doing.
Sono uomo. Lo fai apposta. Lo so che sei arrabbiata.
You really have to start thinking why you're doing that. If there is something that really upsets you, and just think about that. It's a kind of work that you have to do because it's not when people look at you on the set, they think, well, it's easy, she did it. No, you can't sleep at night, you are careful. You have to know what you're doing, otherwise it doesn't come very easy. It doesn't.
Anche a me mancherà. Ma dobbiamo essere felici per lui. È proprio quando non ci credi più che succedono le cose belle.
It is no secret that you are 86 years old.
That's oh,
no
Madonna.
Everybody knows.
Well, you tell everybody.
Everybody.
Why?
No, but now that we have the internet, we can't lie on about
young.
Our age anymore.
I look a little young.
No, you look
a little young. I mean,
86 is the new 56, for sure.
Okay.
But, you know,
I don't
so
like you anymore.
You
it's
started.
Like it's like you don't blink. Same thing. Yes.
So you started at 15.
Yes.
You are now 86. You've been doing this for
lifetime.
For 71 years.
Mm-hmm.
71 years you've been acting, and you've been essentially on top of your game for 71 years. What is, in your opinion, the secret to the longevity of your career?
But it's my life.
So you had no plan B, you had no alternative.
No.
This was what you wanted
yeah,
to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.